I don't know what I'm going to say. Hi. Ever been kicked in the face with a scalpel? I have. It's officially 4 months past post-jaw surgery for me. Not that you care. Deal with my jaw surgery in another episode, I think. Hi. Ever wanted to learn Hindi? I sure do. I cannot take the piss out of myself. It's really hard not to. Hi, I'm Lori, and I'm learning Hindi. Today, I want to give a few tips and tricks on how to start out learning Hindi if you're not sure where to go. I'll show you where I'm up to, and maybe we can connect on social. First up, it makes sense to go to the most free place and the most well-known place, which is Duolingo. So if we take a look now at the Duolingo Hindi, I have done a previous video on this, but you can see where I'm up to now. If you want to search for me and connect with me on Duolingo, you can search for Lori Hindi or Lori Dyer, just there below. And I've done the entire tree once already, and I have one crown, and I'm just sort of partway through going on my second crown too. It's a short tree compared to other ones like French or Italian. But I do think it is a really handy app. The best thing about Duolingo is that, firstly, it is free. And secondly, it's kind of something that you can do anywhere. The thing that's really great about it is that it gets you used to reading the more, like the typewriter, the newspaper style Devanagari script, which is slightly different to the handwriting, which is the same. Because if you think about it, in English, when we handwrite something in cursive or whatever, it looks really different to when you're reading something in the newspaper or on the internet, like in computer writing, if that makes sense. So I think that Duolingo is really good to help you get used to reading, and it's sort of like a really great set of flashcards. The last thing that is really good about Duolingo, and I have spoken about that before, is it's a really great way to get your alphabet, which is the Devanagari characters, up and running. So when I first started, I had no idea, obviously, how to read a foreign alphabet. And this is the quickest and least painful way of getting your Devanagari sort of in your mind as a good basis, as a good starting point. The next software that I want to quickly go over does cost money. I think it's something like maybe, I don't even know what it is in American dollars. I think it's over $100. Australian dollars anyway, and that's Rosetta Stone, and I have done an entire video on that, which I'll link down below as well. When I first started Rosetta Stone, I found it a bit disconcerting because they don't give any explanations, but I guess the concept behind that is that when you learn your first language, so for a lot of you watching this, it could be English, you don't really get someone explaining to you the semantics of English or the grammar of English. You just sort of learn it in an immersion style, which is what they do in Rosetta Stone. I think in the last video, I just sort of done some of the core lessons. But I've actually made my way now up to, this is so slow. I'm now on Unit 7, which is Friends and Social Life, which puts me at level 2 in Rosetta Stone. So I'm just past the halfway point. And I think the thing is, the first one or two levels, the beginner levels, you get a bit of a rush because you get rapid improvement and you're like, this is really cool. And then it starts to get a lot harder and you're like, I could give up now. And that's where most people do. And most people say this is stupid, it's not working. But if you do hate it, I dare say you may not have given it enough of a chance. And no, they're not paying me to do this video. Learning language is really hard. And if you start going through the Rosetta Stone, eventually, I don't know, something in your brain clicks. And I can assure you, I'm naturally very stupid and I learn languages probably slower than you do. And it's taken me probably a year of doing it, not every day, but every other day to get to the halfway point. Some people like Benny Lewis, who I am super inspired by, can learn a language in 3 months. The rest of us who are not as dedicated, it'll take a bit longer. But I have found that I've gotten a lot of value out of Rosetta Stone. I'll do another video on Rosetta Stone when I finish it, which makes sense. And the last piece of software that you have to pay for that I do recommend, and I will do a separate video on in the future, is Langestan. Now, for those who are learning Hindi, a lot of you will already know who Anil Mahato is. He's the biggest name in YouTube on Hindi instruction. After years and years of creating his own content, he's decided to bring it up a level and have his own learning website. I joined probably 8 months ago, and I had a special price because it hadn't fully launched yet. I think it's still going for $99. And I will say, it is totally different to any other software. It feels like you have a one-on-one teacher. It feels like Anil is just talking to you in the videos, which I absolutely love, and it is the only software that I have seen that will actually show you, well, two really important things. The first one, how to pronounce every single sound in Hindi, and he goes over it repeatedly. The second thing that Langastan does better than any other software is it is the only place I found where you can find out how to do the actual brush strokes for the Devanagari, like the alphabet, like how to actually do it. Do you go down first? Do you go out? How do you actually write it? Everything else, you sort of just look at it and identify it. But when it comes to producing it, which is a key part of learning any language, is knowing how to write that and produce that language yourself. Something different between typing a language and actually knowing how to write it down gets to memory better, and it is the only software that I have seen as of yet that does this. If you know of anything else, let me know, and I'll mention it in another video. Just looking at the screen below, it's sort of set out in different modules and different units. I'm currently in level one. There are two levels so far, and I'm up to somewhere in post positions, the effective post positions. I think I am in, I've just finished about, and now I'm going to go into the post position with. Now, if that freaks you out already, don't worry. He walks through it really, really slowly with you, and it's something that it feels really stress-free. But I will give a full review in Hindi when I have finished Anil's course, but so far, so good. The last piece of software, well, it's not actually software, but the last place that I do want to recommend that you can go to if you are learning Hindi is a free website that my Hindi instructor has made. I'll make a link down below. It's called Hindi Express, and you can see it is put into different semesters. University students at the best university in Australia, which is the Australian National University, actually use this website. It's not everything that we use, but it is a big component of our learning in university, and it's here for you for free. He's not going to charge anything for it. Please feel free. He would get an absolute thrill if you were to learn from it, and he can see hits from, you know, all over, from Europe, from America, from New Zealand, wherever. That would really give him a kick to see that. And you just go through and learn your terminology. And if you scroll down, you can see often there are little explanations below. So each one is a little lesson. You can do one per day. And eventually, when you get through all of this, it starts going into different cartoons. And these cartoons, it begins telling stories completely in Hindi, and they're little cartoons that take you through all the different structures. And yes, don't worry, there are translations. So a lot of people ask me, what is the best place to start? What do you recommend? I don't know. So I get a lot of questions about where to start. Some of them are free and some of them are not. I think you're going to find it hard to not pay any money at all to learn Hindi, but at the same time, I have heard of people who've done it just through watching Bollywood movies. I think that would take a lot longer to do that. I think if you were just to immerse yourself in the Indian culture, it would take you a little bit longer than if you're having some tuition and extra help. But yeah, let me know. Have you learned Hindi a different way? Did you just learn it from your parents? Did you go overseas? I would love to know your story as well. So that's it for today. I'll see you next time. The next episode will be in Hindi. Namaskar.